Relaxing Dead, where we will be discussing the latest episodes of AMC's The Walking Dead TV show. Just before we get started, I have a piece of butterscotch hard candy, one of my favorites. I don't like hard candy too much just because of candy, but I do enjoy butterscotch and root beer. So just give me a second. Oh, this is just okay. So, we are going to discuss, I think, episodes 10 and episodes 11. And I just want to real quick apologize for not getting this out sooner. I mean, I know it's not the end of the world, but I was sick. Was it early last week? Not this week, but I think it was the second episode of the second half of this season, season 3. I was a little bit sick, so I couldn't get that. So I fell behind two episodes. So, anyway, I'm not gonna be able to recap both episodes fully, but, so, prior to this last episode where Merle and Daryl end up back at the prison, and Andrea also, and what happens with her and the governor, she goes back to Woodbury. So that's the latest episode. I don't have the episode title offhand. The episode before that, which I think is number 10, that episode was where continued off where everyone left Woodbury or escaped Woodbury. Rick and company rescued Glenn and Maggie. Merle and Daryl were also able to escape in the fray. And of course, Daryl and Merle were trying to reunite. So in the episode that followed that, we had Merle and Daryl in the woods. And we also had Rick outside the prison gates, seeing more visions of Lori. And we also had that episode where I believe it was that episode where the governor showed up with the truck, or was that the episode? Episodes confused a little bit. Okay. Anyway, so the part with Rick seeing visions of Lori, he's starting to lose it. And that coincides with what happens in the comic book. Because in the comic book, he doesn't see visions of her. What happens is she calls him on the phone. But this happens after they leave the prison. And they end up at another place, another house, temporarily. And in that house, the phone rings. And they have this conversation with these people, pretty much. And Lori ends up speaking with him. is seeing here in the TV show, I find that very touching and very, you know, it's kind of a, I don't want to say sad, but like it's a touching moment, you know. It's a shame that, you know, he never got to say goodbye to Lori. And she was killed. And that's what happened in the comic book. And but then sometimes, you know, it's this is what I like about movies and good writing is that it makes you think that it's real. You know, it can tug on your heartstrings. And that's what I like with good shows, good films. Not just that they're an escape, but they make it seem very real and believable and all that. And I'm more prone to be impacted by something that's emotionally charged. So those scenes were, I thought they were pretty touching. It's also showing that Rick is losing it. And probably shouldn't be the leader. Now, I'm going to spoil some things here. In the comic book, Tyrese's group shows up at prior to the prison. Rick and company meet Tyrese on the way out of Atlanta, from what I remember. Now, in the show, Tyrese, you know, that group of four people that showed up at the prison, Tyrese, the girl, and the two other guys, Rick scares the crap out of them, so they end up leaving the prison and end up in Woodbury. And as soon as they ended up crossing paths with Andrea in the woods, and how, governor's right-hand man now, that crazy scientist guy, I can't remember his name offhand, Milton was talking about taking people in, and now they show up at Woodbury about to give the governor the layout of the prison. That doesn't happen in the comic book, but I like it because it's a different twist. Apparently Rick's group and Tyrese's group may not end up together after all. I don't know. It remains to be seen, but it's an interesting twist, which is cool because it's unexpected. It's one thing about the TV show compared to the comics is that while, for the most part, everything is closely in line, aligned with each other, there are certain plot elements like this that are different, and that's good because it keeps things, you just not know what to expect. So that's an interesting twist, what's going to happen with Tyrese and his group, and if they're going to be part of the attack on the prison. And then we have Andrea, you know, trying to convince the governor not to attack the prison, of her friends are still there or whatever, and she seems torn, and she ends up going back to the prison and reuniting, and everyone's very skeptical of her, and you know, she's acting like what Michonne said, having a messiah complex, and she's very militant and defensive, and finally she ends up breaking down a little bit and wanting to do something to help them. So she ends up, you know, going back to the governor, and he knows that she left because Milton told him, but she doesn't know that he knows. So that will be interesting to see how that plays out. And of course she couldn't kill the governor. They told her to go back and they could end this now, and she didn't. And I, at that point, when she had the, you know, she was standing over the governor, and she had the knife, you know, ready, or getting ready to, I think she was just kind of pointing. is, while he was sleeping, I was waiting for him to, like, open his one eye and grab her wrist, or wake up. I didn't think she was gonna be able to kill him. Of course she didn't. So, it's gonna be interesting to see what happens. What I don't like about Andrea's character, it's like, she's really naive, and I don't know how her character relates to what character she represents in the comic book, because I can't remember. In the comic book, I'm not sure if there's an Andrea or not, but in the comic book, there's another character that's very good with a gun, a rifle, and she was in the comic book, she was Dale's friend. It's been a while since I read them, so I think Andrea is supposed to represent that character. But Andrea in the comic book never ends up sleeping with the governor or anything like this, so that's a different plot twist too. But what's funny is that Andrea saw Michonne having a fight with the governor. She saw the fish tanks. I don't remember if she saw the governor's daughter, zombie daughter. I think she did, because the governor was, like, petting her or something. I don't remember. And now she knows the truth about the governor, how he attacked the prison. And it's just, like, she continues to just be this naive and be in love with the governor. And, like, look, I can understand the zombie apocalypse being so crazy and just shattering your entire belief system in the world and everything, but I don't think you would lose your humanity. You wouldn't just all of a sudden just be like, oh, zombies in the zombie heads in the aquariums, oh, okay, no big deal. Oh, you are a psychopath and you attacked my friends, no big deal. that's nothing. I know she went through a lot, but that kind of character flaw just kind of irks me. It's like, how do you get past seeing this person with zombie heads in the aquarium and still want to have sex with them, you know? I mean, I think that's a little bit of turn off, you know? Pet peeves, dark chocolate, heavy metal, and zombie heads in fish tanks. I don't know, that's just, nobody likes her, but I think you need that character. You gotta have that annoying, antagonistic kind of character besides the governor. You can't just have everybody. I don't know. I like it. As much as I don't like her, she adds something more to it. Does she need to be on the show? Does her character need to be in the show? The show might progress more without her. Apparently this season is all about the prison. So, you know, I guess it's alright. It's alright by me for the most part. So enough about her, bitch. Now we talk about Meryl and Daryl. Oh, by the way, I forget the actress's name that plays Andrew, but that's, I mean, she's a great actress. I really like her as an actress because she's annoying. She pulls off that character well. Now we have Andrew, and then we have Merle and Daryl, and I thought that was a touching scene when there was that back and forth between Merle and Daryl in the woods. And Daryl was like, we're going back to the prison and all this, and I forget all the talk, the dialogue exactly. And then they went up to the bridge to save the you know, there's a kid there. And then Daryl and Merle got into more of a heated debate. And then they were getting ready to fight. And that's when Merle grabbed his, you know, younger brothers, he grabbed Daryl's shirt, tore it off, and that's when he sees all the scars. and Merle said something like, I had to get out of there or something, or I was going to kill him or something. And then you could see both of them getting kind of, you can see how it affected them. They pulled that scene off pretty well. It was very touching. It was like two brothers having a heart to heart. They had their guard down. And you can see Merle getting upset. You can see Daryl getting upset, visibly somewhat shaken up. And, you know, Daryl's like, you know what? I'm walking away, but you're leaving. And so he leaves Merle. But then, of course, they reunite and end up helping Rick and the people at the camp after the governor attacked them. So, this is just a guess, but I think that Tyrese and company have left, are not going to be joining up with Rick, and I think that Rick is probably going to be splitting leadership with Merle or with Daryl. So, I could be wrong, and maybe the Tyrese and company come to Rick and company's group's help. Now, I'm thinking maybe Tyrese and them, they join up with the governor, or, you know, or Andrea finds out that Tyrese and company was with Rick and crew, and they turn against the governor. I think something's going to happen a little bit differently than the comic book, because in the comic book, the governor and crew, they come to the prison and they tear it up, and shit really goes down real bad, and that's how Lori dies in a gunfight. But this is different now, so we have, it's going to be interesting to see how all this turns out. We have 5 episodes left, I think 8 episodes per half of the season, you know, 4 or 5 I would think left. So so we have Merle and Daryl back. Rick doesn't fully trust Merle, but I would like to keep company with Merle. He's sketchy, but he's a loyal. I think he's a loyal. He's a bad guy, but he's not a bad guy, if you know what I mean. The governor is a bad guy, and a bad guy. So Merle, you know, we'll see what happens there. I don't think he's got loyalty with the governor. He never had. His loyalty is with his brother. You know, Rick still doesn't trust Michonne. But towards the end of the last episode, Rick and Michonne, and apparently Carl, are gonna go on a run. Maybe after the back to Woodbury. But in the next episode, the previews for the next episode, it looks like they end up somewhere else, not at Woodbury. So maybe they're making a run for weapons or something. I don't know. It's gonna be interesting to see next episode. But I gotta say, the last 2 episodes are very good. The first episode of the second half, not so much, seemed forced. But these last 2 episodes, I like a lot. So it's good to have things going and getting really interesting. Of course, we have the governor show up at the prison and killed the one prisoner who I didn't think he was going to get killed. And I forget his name. But he got shot right in the head by the governor. And luckily that Carol didn't get shot, but she had to lay behind dead prisoner's body the whole time while he's getting riddled with bullets. And then we have everyone else trying to fend off the 4 or 5 members of the governor's crew that showed up at the prison. And then comes the big van, busts into the prison, and unloads a bunch of zombies. And everybody's freaking out. Now, here's the other part of this. All throughout the prison, they're bashing in the zombies, they're pushing them away, and Michonne is just lopping off their heads with the sword. You know, these zombies aren't powerful, and they don't run fast like 28 days later. So I don't know why everybody's freaking out. Oh my gosh, you unloaded a van of 20 zombies in the yard, and we have all these guns, and we know how to kill them. And oh my gosh, it was like you have everybody in the prison trying to defend themselves. You have your group outside the prison. You just bust in with the van. Why not bust all the way in? I was waiting for a whole crew of people to come out of the van and start shooting up the place. But so I thought that was a little weak. But it's gonna set something up with whatever plan, with whatever plans the governor has. Now, I don't know why the governor and crew say, "Hey, there was only like five of us there," the governor and his crew, and they have to know that there's not that many people there at the prison, because if the prison had a lot of people, they would have come running out to help defend the place. So if I was the governor, I'd go back and immediately come right back with more people. But maybe that's the problem. Maybe the governor, he only has the four or five people that can shoot weapons and stuff. So maybe that's all his crew. Anyway, so that's gonna be interesting. So yeah, so normally in the beginning of this video, we go over viewer comments and discussions about the Walking Dead. But because I missed two episodes, I didn't really have time for all that. So I promise we'll get to your comments. Just drop some comments. What you think of the last two episodes? What you think so far? The next Relaxing Dead episode, we'll go over your comments first, and then we'll discuss the most recent episode. Yeah, so really digging it. Let me know what you think. I'd like to hear from you. And that should do it. Until next time. So thanks for stopping by. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. Appreciate your support as always. And until next time.